How is everybody doing on this lovely, lovely Wednesday afternoon? It's been a minute since I've had to talk anything football related when it comes to the regular season, but here we are, and I'm repping my Eagles. You already know. This isn't the Eagles' little preview video or my prediction just yet. This is the NFL Week 1 predictions. I'm going to make my predictions on every single game, minus the Friday night Eagles Packers in Brazil matchup. And let me know what you guys think about whatever game piques your interest the most. There are some pretty interesting matchups and a couple that are kind of whatever. But regardless, I wanted to talk about this week and the slate of games. I have a couple of upsets and I'll explain my thought process on those. But as always, Thursday Night Football, we're going to start it off in Kansas City as the Ravens head down to Kansas City for an AFC Championship rematch against the Kansas City Chiefs. This one, I'm starting off with a bang. We're going to have an upset here. I believe the Chiefs are like a 3 or 4 point favorite right now. Either way, they're favorites. And I got them losing this game. No Hollywood Brown. I'm not going to knock on Andy Reid or anything like that, but I just don't see how a team as good as they are, can battle it out with the Ravens, who have just acquired one of the best running backs in the league, one that can take over a game, and Derrick Henry. I don't know. I think the Ravens this year have truly their best chance at making a run for the Super Bowl under Lamar Jackson, and Derrick Henry is a big reason. I got this game 31-21 in favor of the Ravens. Following that, we're going straight to the Sunday games. I'll talk about the Eagles and the Packers on Thursday, so stay tuned for that. Falcons and the Steelers, I believe that one is in Atlanta as well. I got the Falcons. That's going to be an interesting game. Kirk Cousins on his brand new team, Russell Wilson on his brand new team. It's just, they're kind of two teams that you know are going to be pretty good, but you're not going to really care about it too much. And the matchup itself is nothing truly exciting, you know? I got the Falcons taking that one, though, 24-21. I think both teams are going to be good this year. You know, the AFC North is pretty loaded, and the South in the NFC is whatever. There's no true standout in that division. But I guess on paper, the Falcons have the most talented team. I don't know. We're going to have to wait and see. But I got the Falcons winning a three-point affair right there. Bills-Cardinals. It's the Bills. The Bills are going to win that game. They're one of my favorites in the AFC. Probably top five team in the AFC. And I only say that because of Josh Allen. You know, I know they've lost a few pieces on the defensive side. They lost Stephon Diggs. I understand all of that. But I think that this team is still coached well enough that they're going to compete, and they have one of the best quarterbacks in the NFL. It's no matter what, they're going to be up there in the conversation, and they're going to beat the Cardinals, who are still in a very deep rebuild. They're going to win that one 31-17. Following that game, the Cincinnati Bengals, New England Patriots. Bengals are winning that one. I got them winning that 28-13. The Patriots, realistically, are the worst team in football. And the Bengals, with Joe Burrow coming back, T. Higgins is still there. I feel strongly about the Bengals as well being a pretty solid, formidable team. And after that, we got Bears, Titans, in another really interesting matchup that no one really cares about. Though the Bears are probably going to be a pretty good team. I would say that they're going to be up there, for sure. The Titans, on the other hand, they could be a sneaky, solid team, but I don't really see them standing out too much in an AFC with the whole East and the North, the Chiefs in one division. I don't see them making much noise. And then they have the Houston Texans to deal with in their own division. So, yeah, this matchup here, it's going to be an interesting one. I don't see anything that the Titans truly have that are going to wow me. I know you got Calvin Ridley and DeAndre Hopkins and whatnot, but still, I don't know. They'll be able to put up points and compete, no doubt. They're not a bad team. It's just they're not a standout team. So I'm gonna go ahead and say the Bears 34-21. something like that. I think Caleb Williams is going to really show up and show out. And DJ Moore, DeAndre Swift, and the whole squad down there. The Bears got something cooking, and I'm honestly really excited to see how the NFC North, the AFC North is loaded. I'm excited to see the NFC North do its thing, so we'll see how that goes. Texans, Colts, AFC South showdown. Texans are going to win this one. I got it pretty close, 30-23. I think the Colts are going to be pretty solid as well. Anthony Richardson just needs to stay healthy. Jonathan Taylor's in the background. Michael Pittman on the outside. I mean, Colts got a decent offense, so I think that they'll be able to keep up, but not enough to deal with the team that the Texans have built down there. They look really good, so got them winning that one. Dolphins, Jaguars. Sorry, Doug Peterson. 37-14. Dolphins are going to beat you guys. You guys have nothing truly going on for you. You lost Calvin Ridley to Tennessee. You still have Josh Allen. You still have Trevor Lawrence, but he hasn't emerged as a true quarterback in my eyes. I haven't seen it. And I hope that changes for the sake of your team, for the future of Doug Peterson's career as a coach there. But something's got to give, and not against the Dolphins, unfortunately. They're going to be high-powered as always. Tyreek Hill is going to be running all over the place. Tua is going to do what he does, and he's going to game manage and make the best out of what he can do, winning you the football game. So, yeah, moving on from that one, the New Orleans Saints, Carolina Panthers, an NFC South showdown. Saints are winning this one, 24-10. Panthers, objectively second-worst team in the NFL. It's pretty obvious. They've done some good things, but at the end of the day, they are still a ways away from really competing with the Saints and the Falcons and the Buccaneers. Those three teams are going to be fighting out for the division in a 9-10 win division. So, yeah, good luck to the Panthers, but the Saints are going to win that one. Giants versus Vikings. Now, if you asked me a few weeks ago before J.J. McCarthy got hurt, I would say Vikings are going to win this one, but unfortunately, I'm going to give this one to the Giants in an upset. Got a 21-17. Ugly, sloppy win for the Giants to start out the season. You're welcome. This is the one and only time you'll probably see me give you guys a win. Actually, no. I probably got you guys winning next week, and then you're going to go on potentially the biggest losing streak of the season. So, good luck. Chargers, Raiders. Two teams that really don't have much to wow me. I mean, the Chargers really just lost everything and everyone. Mike Williams and Keenan Allen and Austin Eckler. I mean, and Justin Herbert isn't really 100% either. So I'm giving them the win, but I wouldn't be surprised if the Raiders win this one. I don't know. We'll see how that one goes. Super Bowl 50 rematch. Seahawks and the Broncos in Seattle. I got the Seahawks winning a 19-17 affair. Bo Nix is going to be pretty impressive, make a few little mistakes, and Geno Smith is going to capitalize and lead his team to a game winner at the end. It's going to be an interesting one for sure, though. As long as DK and Tyler Lockett and all of them down there do their thing, and Geno, you know, kind of brings back the 2022 Geno. Nothing against last year. I feel like he did fine. But if he can play like he did when he first got the job in Seattle a couple of years ago, Seahawks can make some noise for sure. Nothing compared to what the Rams or the 49ers are going to do, but they'll compete and they'll be there. That's for sure. Browns, Cowboys in Cleveland. This is another... Well, actually, no, the Browns are favorites right now by like one. I think it's almost even right now. And then the closer we get to Sunday, it's going to become even. I got the Browns winning 31-28. I think that's going to be one of the best games of the whole entire week one slate. And it's going to be the Browns defense going up against that high-powered offense of the Cowboys. And I think there's going to be one or two mistakes that the Cowboys make that give the Browns the edge, or the one or two plays that the Browns defense is going to make that will give them the edge. But I think they're going to eke that one out. It could go either way, though, truly. And I'm rooting for the Browns. You already know that, but it could really go either way. Now we got the Buccaneers, Commanders. I'm already rooting for the Buccaneers as much as I don't want to, but at the same time, they're playing the Commanders, and the Commanders, they're not awful. They really aren't. They have some good pieces. I'm really interested in seeing Jaden Daniels perform, you know, play at a NFL caliber level. He's got talent. So I'm not sleeping on the Commanders. They could be a surprise 7-9 win team this year if all the cards fall in their favor. That's my thing. Injuries always plague a team. A new head coach and all of that, you know, it's going to take time to really settle in, and by that point it might be too late, given who they have on their schedule. And their schedule, just like the Giants, not very favorable, and the Cowboys even, not very favorable for them given where they're at right now team-wise. So, best of luck to them, JC. Shout out to you. We'll see how it goes. But I got the Bucks 24-20. Pretty close game. Baker leads a game-winning touchdown drive to beat you guys in Tampa. That's what I got. Sunday Night Football. These are the two games right here that I really wanted to talk about. The Rams and the Lions in Detroit. A rematch of the playoff game last year that saw Matt Stafford return to Detroit to try and shut them out of winning a playoff game and making a run for the Super Bowl. And they did it. They pulled it off. The Lions won that one, but this time around, I don't think it's going to be like that. Cooper Kupp is back. You got Puka Nacua and you got Matt Stafford all reuniting as healthy as can be. I'm giving the Rams the edge, 31-24. It's going to be a really, really good game, but I feel like one of the reasons why they lost last year in the championship game is going to be a reason here. The coach and just the way, like, I love the way that the Lions head coach, you know, treats his team. He believes in them. He trusts them to do everything and anything. No matter what down it is, he's going for it. No matter what the distance is, he's going for it. No matter where they're at on the field, he's got the confidence in his players to do it. But sometimes it could be a little bit much, and it proved that way in the championship, and maybe he's learned from his mistakes, and maybe he does everything right. But I think the Rams are going to overwhelm this team early on, and they're going to take this win from the Lions to start out the season in a really good Sunday Night Football game. But now Monday Night Football. The New York Jets back at Monday Night Football to start the season, but instead of against Buffalo at home, they're on the road in San Francisco. What a matchup that is. Aaron Rodgers, Brock Purdy, Kyle Shanahan, Robert Saleh. It's going to be interesting. Two really good defenses with two really solid, talented offenses. Like, you can't get anything better than that on primetime Monday Night Football. Like, Joe Buck and Troy Aikman got a good one that night, that's for sure. As much as I'm rooting for the Jets, and I will definitely be rooting for the Jets, go Rodgers, please find a way to win this football game. I got the Niners winning this one, 33-27, a very close, high-scoring game. It's going to see a lot of action, a lot of good defensive play, a lot of explosive offensive plays. I think we're going to really see the full power of this Jets offense with Rodgers at the helm, surviving more than four snaps. And we're going to see Brock Purdy and Brandon Ayuk and Debo and all of those same guys doing what they've been doing the past couple of years. And play really good football, put up points, and Kyle Shanahan's going to deliver a game plan that's going to be really fun to watch for sure. How could I forget Christian McCaffrey, obviously. If you guys got him in fantasy, you're lucky sons of bitches. This is going to be a fun one, and I can't wait for it. And I still have one more game to talk about, but I'm going to save that for the next video. Let me know, you guys, what you think about my picks, what your picks are. How you feel about going into 2024? It's going to be an interesting season. A lot of familiar faces in different places and a lot of high expectation on a bunch of teams this year with a lot of newcomers coming in as well with a lot of upside. It's going to be a lot of fun watching this season go, and we're right there. It's tomorrow night and I cannot wait any longer. I just can't. I cannot. I might not be super energetic. I'm a little bit tired, but trust me, I'm very excited. Let me know your thoughts, and I'll see you all in the next one. Fly, Eagles, fly. Peace out.